1977, Craig Vetter moved his motorcycle fairing company from Illinois to San Luis Obispo. Now, by then, his Windjammer was well established as the most widely used touring fairing in the world, and Vetter motorcycle luggage was equally popular. But Vetter was eager to move on to other projects, and as more motorcycle manufacturers began selling touring accessories as original equipment, he decided to sell the company. In his own words, Craig Vetter explained, "The reason I was attracted to motorcycles originally was that motorcycles got 40 miles to the gallon and cars just got 15. Anything I did to make motorcycles better transportation meant more people would ride them, more fuel would be saved, and there would be less inclination to go to the Arab oil fields. It seems to me that my part is to help reduce our country's dependence on foreign oil, to make it last longer, and to make it less likely to send our boys off to the oil fields." Richard Etzler graduated from Cal Poly in 1967. Engineers in all disciplines were in great demand in most industries. With a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering, he was hired immediately by Pacific Gas and Electric's General Construction Division. It didn't occur to him at the time that he would soon be in charge of building and starting up a nuclear power plant. Etzler was construction and startup manager from 1978 through 1984, and the outage manager from 1988 to his retirement in 1995 from Diablo Canyon. Completed in 1968, the $18 million Lopez Dam was celebrated throughout the Central Coast as state-of-the-art. The water that quickly collected behind it was seen as a giant step forward in flood control. The cities downstream, Arroyo Grande, Grover Beach, Oceano, and Pismo Beach, were all water users who saw the new lake as an important source and counted themselves lucky to have it. The same water attracted recreational users, boaters, fishermen, and swimmers. Campers and picnickers enjoyed the scenic hospitality of its shores. In 2001, more than 400,000 visitors made their way up the 8-mile road to the dam east of Arroyo Grande. In 30 years, Lopez had become a good neighbor, good for citizens, business people, and tourists. And the dam was reliable, or so everyone thought. Until after 3 decades of untroubled use, the California State Division of Safety of Dams stepped in with some bad news. Lopez Dam had become a high-risk structure. Something had to be done, and the solution would not be easy. Strengthening the Lopez Dam took place in 2001, a project that involved moving 500,000 cubic yards of soil and adding hundreds of stone columns made by drilling into the ground to bedrock and then filling the holes with compacted gravel. Once complete, the soil was replaced on the lower face of the dam. Lopez would be the first dam to use stone technology to obtain California State Division of Safety of Dams approval.